as we welcomed a new name to the channel with our last review, it seemed only too fitting that we say hello to another, as I'm very excited to welcome into the fold Canterbury's Flock Brewing. To be fair, the beer itself is actually a pressure drop brew, but it has been some time since we last featured them too. And with the quality that they pump out, that's far too long. So let's flip that switch with some lasting lights. Flock have made a name for themselves as Hazy Titans. So when it came time for Pressure Drop to find some new collaborators, it was a no-brainer. And of course, only one style was gonna win out. This New England IPA emanates softness and light. From its cheerful orange glow to its delicate fruity sherbet fizz, this brew is a shining beacon of flavor and joy. Hopped with the Amarillo, the Econot, the El Dorado, and the Mosaic, we should definitely expect a lot of that New England juice, some classic citrus notes, and maybe even a touch on the earthy or herbal or even resinous side. And at a nice weighty 7.3% ABV, we should expect some weight to it too. Over the last couple of years, Pressure Drop IPAs have really been some of the best. And from the one or two of Flocks I've had so far, they sure aren't bad either. So let's lighten things up. Let's get pouring. So there is a lot of pineapple right up top. It's got some bright citrusy notes in there. And an almost soft blossom note. There are some sweet stone fruit, maybe peach or apricot coming out of it too. So there are sweet fruits, almost a fruit salad-y note right up top. But it is surprisingly gentle in the mouth, very, very soft, especially for a 7%er. And in fact, I think I'm right in saying the last couple of brews we've tried have been quite soft up top too. So I don't know if that's a trending theme, or if I'm just suffering from a little big IPA burnout. And it's those citrus notes that really burst into the middle. There's a real lemon and limey note to it, with an ever so subtle herbal or even peppery quality, as it fades out with an almost earthy herbal bitterness. And although there is a soft, juicy tropical note right up top, it's more green fruits that are really packing out the brew. There's a soft apple note and a real dominant melon. And along with those fizzy citrus notes, the beer does feel light and bright and really uplifting. And now we're dimming into the final third. It's been another fresh, almost green brew. Although, unlike the one we had previously, not green in a grassy sense, more in a green fruity way. I definitely was expecting this to be something of a tropical juice bomb, as I was expecting this to be full of juicy tropical notes, especially up top. But in fact, it's been another that's been very, very gentle, with soft and subtle notes like apple and melon really dominating the brew. Couple that with those bright citrus notes, that lemon and lime, it all comes together with a bright yet refreshing kick. They themselves refer to it as something of a summer beach party, and I'd only add a summer beach party on some kind of tropical island, one with fresh fruit growing aplenty. And to further compound that green theme, there's a real herbal and piney bitterness in the tail, and those piney notes really do linger long in the mouth. It's almost eucalyptus-like in its aftertaste. So it's another that's taking me in a direction I had not been anticipating. But I sure do love that these guys are keeping us on our toes.